Welcome to Multicam Video Editing on LumaFusion. Hi, I'm Stu. Today, I'm going to show you where you can edit. Not one, not two, not three, but six tracks of video. And auto-sync them all with an audio master track. Let's get started. Hi, I'm Stu. Welcome back to another LumaFusion video tutorial. This is part three of our multicam studio edit series. And in this tutorial, we're going to look at creating a six camera video edit using the multicam studio container. And we're also going to add in the original master audio as well. So this was shot by LumaTouch, probably Scott, and we've got multiple camera options. So cam one is a straight on shot, you can see here, and towards the end we get some breakdancers going on there as well. Cam two is a close up of the breakdancers. Now they don't do anything in the first part of the video, but in the last sort of minute 13, we've got the breakdancers going on. So I've already placed an in and an out point to relate to that. Okay, so moving on from cam 2, cam 3 we've got this wide shot here at a lower angle but closer to the stage. So this could be considered one of our main shots, but it's the next two shots that interest me the most. Cam 4 is stage right, and I'll probably use this as one of my main sequences. And then cam 5 is from the opposite direction. And to finish off, we've got a slightly closer up shot of the breakdancing. Once again, I've placed an in and an out point a little bit closer to that footage because we don't need the 2 minutes odd at the beginning of the video. So we have the breakdancing there, which we can cut into the edit nicely. To get started, I'm going to do this in a couple of ways. I'm going to select the first three clips plus the master audio track, and then I'm going to drag and drop the last clips in. Easiest way for me to do this is cam 4 is what I was interested in. So we'll take cam 4 and then we'll tap on the multi-selection tool, and we'll take cam 5 as our second shot, and then we'll go to cam 3 as our close-up to the stage. So we've still got cam 1, cam 2 and cam 6 to bring in, and then we'll also bring in the master audio track. I'm then going to go down to the plus symbol. I'm going to tap on multicam container, four clips. So that's three video, one audio. Tap on that. We'll then go into the synchronizer. So tap on synchronizer, give ourselves a bit more room so you can see what's going on. Now the synchronizer has recognized that we have a master audio track. It has muted out all the other audio tracks. So the scratch audio that's in cam 4, 5 and 3 has been switched off effectively. And we're just going to be working from the master audio. So obviously with cams 4, 5 and 3, there is a slight clap, but the master audio doesn't have that. It's just the actual music track probably done in the studio. So it's purely relying upon the waveforms of the music to get everything aligned properly. Again, you're going to go down to press the sync, and we're going to want audio. You can press audio or automatic. Again, if you were working with footage that has timecode embedded in it, you can press timecode or you can choose none, but we're going to choose audio. So tap that. It's a little bit longer to sync this amount of footage. It's not quite as quick as just doing a single piece of footage and audio as in the first video tutorial, or even the three video interview that we had in the second video tutorial. And there we go, that's it synced in. So what we can do is just play it through to make sure it's working. So we'll just give ourselves a little bit more breathing space in the preview window and press play. Music seems to come in at the right time. Lighting comes up. And that seems to be working well. Okay, so that is our main video tracks in place. We've got stage right, stage left, and then the close-up low angle, slightly wide of the band facing forwards. Let's first of all bring in cam one for the wide shot, dump that in sequence four, and you'll see the audio gets automatically muted. And then from there, I've just tapped away from it. I'm then gonna bring in the two breakdancing clips. So cam two, and then finally cam six on the sixth track. Now you'll note they're really, really short in comparison to the other clips. Again, we go in This time we'll tap automatic, it doesn't really make any difference, and that will then resynchronize all of the clips together. So the point I'm doing this is to show that whether you're pre-selecting the clips and adding them to a multicam container, or whether you're dragging and dropping them into a blank multicam container, it works exactly the same, and it shouldn't really trip up the actual software itself from syncing. If it does do, you can manually correct it. As you can see, everything has been synced, and of course our video clips of the breakdancers are at the back end, which is where we need them to be. Let's look at this one as well. And then we've got our wide shot, and then our wide shot closer in, stage left, stage right. I think that's everything that we need here. That's us. So in the next part, we're going to use the switcher and we're going to start editing these clips together. Okay, rather than start from scratch with these, I've actually pre-selected quite a few of the clips. And I'm just going to go in and show you that and start to show you the process of tapping between the different cuts and that. But let's just play some of it through for a second or two. Just stop it here. This rapper then walks on stage and starts doing his thing. And what you'll notice is I've kept the cuts quite lengthy and reasonably chill between the different points. But once we get to the rapper, I've speeded up the selection process. So let's take a look at that. And basically, when you are editing a music video, you're kind of editing to the beat to a certain extent, but you're certainly editing to the pace of the video. This is a quite a chill, you know, laid back song. So long, slow cuts that we can work in between are kind of the order of the day for this kind of video. But if you had something that had a lot more energy in it, then you would have been cutting a heck of a lot faster. And obviously a dance video, EDM music, that kind of thing, you're going to cut a lot faster between the different clips. And some clips might last only frames long, literally 6 or 7 frames, or just slightly longer than half a second, and then you're moving on to the next clip, just so your brain processes the information and no more, and then you're on to the next sort of clip in general. So if we highlight the actual multicam clip into the switcher, and then you can see, if I just back up on it, you can see the different colors have been selected and juggled between. So all I'm doing when I've made these different cuts is tapped on the little preview windows above, and that's then made the selection for me. So if we actually play through, we're on this first clip here. So if we just sort of start to play, and if we cut to the wide shot here, back to this one, and then back to this one. Now, if I wanted to, and I wanted to sort of line things up so that this guy coming in here, we actually see him on the V1 clip, and what we can do is, using the up and down arrows on our keyboard, we can then just reposition things, or you can highlight the clip itself, it's up to you. And let's say we go to, I quite like a bit here, so press play, and then just... back to here. Then we'll stop at this point, and you'll notice just prior to around about here, the breakdancing clips have switched themselves on, because at that point they come into the mix, so we can cut into them as well. So we just play that back now. So like, so at that point there, if we we don't like that clip there, we can come into it, pinch and zoom the likes of, that's okay. So let's just ripple it along and shorten things somewhat. Take it to there, play it through again. That's just better pacing. So then come to here and see if we could switch to this point. Okay, so I've moved back to this clip, which is just at the end of this guy's rap. And what I thought I would do is switch to the wide shot here. So press play, tap. There we go, that is the end of the edit. So we can just take it back a bit, make sure we're happy with all the shots. Starting about here. Okay, so that's the edit pretty much done. Now, the cool thing about a multicam container is that it's now just one layer. You can effectively layer over the top of it if you want to. And also, you could export this out and then bring it back into another project timeline and then start to work with it there. So it gives you the opportunity to very simply tap and edit multiple clips very, very easily. And that's the main thing. It's going to make everybody's life a lot easier when it comes to doing these kind of edits. And what I would say is, if you're not into using multicam in terms of have multiple cameras, and you may be just using your iPhone or your Galaxy S22 or 23 or whatever, then this can still be used really, really effectively for syncing audio and video on an individual basis. And also in the next video tutorial, I'll show you how you can make the most of using it with just one video file, which we will apply different effects to and then use the multicam to edit that together. So there's different ways of actually using the multicam studio to make the most of it. Thanks very much to Lumatouch for providing this footage. I have no clue who the band are. So there we go. If you've enjoyed this video tutorial, by all means, give it a thumbs up. If I've earned your subscription today, please subscribe to the channel, and I will catch you on the next one. See you later.